This is part two of the fire videos. More today. On November 18th, I went in to try to get back in and was stopped by the police again. So Canaan Road was closed, they said, because there were down power lines. So having also heard that Las Virgenes had been part of the fire, I thought I'd try to get some shots to show you that. So here we are on Las Virgenes Road, and off to the right you can see that there's the power company fixing power lines. And when you see what the reason for it behind those lines, all of this area was burned. It's just completely blackened. This was a park. And the damage just goes on and on and on. There goes a fire truck in the distance. The surface of the ground is just black. A lot of the trees are burnt. Look at all of the ash under that one. Which was a little difficult because I had to kind of shoot into the sun, so I've got a little bit of the propeller shadows falling into the lens, but we'll swing around here in just a moment. Lifting off again and going to the other side of the street where there's a building that got really close to the fire. They were really lucky. The firemen protected this. Whatever this building is, you can see that some of the fence melted there. But again, it's just this area was just completely wasted. Here we are at Liberty Canyon, and this gives you, again, a bit more of an idea of the scope of this fire. This was quite a ways away from where we just were, and the hillsides are completely black. And what's interesting about this shot is that once you get above the crest of this hill, off to the upper right, you can see that the little residential section was rescued by the firemen. And it's still green over there. I just thought that was amazing. And swinging around here, you can see another little set of buildings. This, I believe, is a daycare center, and there was fire on both sides of it, and it survived. Miraculous. That's the 101 freeway off to the left. You can see traffic's moving on it normally. They don't have it shut down anymore. Have a better view of it here in a moment. We'll get to the top of this hill. Burnt trees and everything else. You can see the freeway, how close this fire came to the freeway. And now we're a bit worried about what's going to happen the next time it rains, which is supposed to be this week. Next is something that's a little creepy. We learned that the Woolsey fire started very close to the old Santa Susana field laboratories that held the area near RocketDyne, where they had a nuclear power near meltdown in 1959. That area is still to this day somewhat contaminated by radioactive elements. This is the road to Box Canyon, which is very close to that area. And we're about to see a piece of a documentary that I thought was really well done about this whole situation, and even Kim Kardashian's got involved with it. This is the plant as it looks today, and here we go.
And did you have some role or some recollection that you wanted to pass on regarding the sodium burn pit?
Oh yes, well,
tell people what that was first.
Okay, it was a pit where like a small lake. And they took the various chemicals, and especially sodium and NAC. NAC and sodium are both used primarily for the coolants in the primary cooling system of reactors. It disperses the heat. Well, they would take this used NAC after it was removed from the reactor out, put it in drums, 55-gallon drums, take it to the sodium burn pit, put it in a small rowboat, one drum at a time, and row it out to the center of the lake, push the drum in the water, and then row back and get behind the coverage of a blockhouse. And they would shoot the drum with a 30-06 rifle, therefore allowing the water to seep into the drum. And when water comes in contact with NAC or sodium, it's a very serious explosion. And this is the way that they burned off this waste material, as well as other chemicals and so on.
It was quite unusual. Normally, you dispose of radioactive materials in specially designed and licensed radioactive waste facilities. So open-air burning was not supposed to occur for anything radioactive, but we did it anyway.
So this burning was in the open air overlooking Simi Valley.
And absolutely. The smoke would travel all over the complex up there, including RocketDyne and the Atomics International Complex, and it would travel into Simi Valley as well as the San Fernando Valley.
And radioactive and chemical waste really weren't supposed to be burned there, just clean sodium, but they ended up having a fair amount of radioactivity and chemicals. And we've got now contamination both in the groundwater beneath that site, and some of it migrated off-site to what was then the Brandeis Camp Institute.
Yes, that is true.
Went on for decades. And it was conducted in part because a famous memorandum by a company official that it was costly and took a lot of time to get the appropriate permits and ship the material off for appropriate disposals.
The whole Box Canyon area was once where they shot some of the scenes from the television series Star Trek. But it's also where Kim Kardashian is calling for a cleanup of the area, which I think everyone would welcome. But the fact that all of this material was simply burned in a body of water and that they did it repeatedly and then it went out over into the atmosphere is a bit alarming, to say the least. So we'll have to keep watch about this.